basic concepts of indexing in database management system. Myself, Rashmi Dikshit. So let us begin the session. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain need and basics of indexing. Why indexing is required? What are the different types of indexing? Students are going to learn at the end of this session. So let us begin the session. So why indexing is used? This is a basic scenario or architecture. CPU, control processing unit, random access memory and hard disk. Data is stored in the hard disk. Whatever the different tables, whatever the different records in the table are stored in the hard disk, which is a secondary memory. Whenever any user fires a query, that is, for example, consider select star from student where roll number is 1. If user want to find a record of a student for a particular roll number, he or she will fire a query. Central processing unit will process that query. Now, how a communication takes place between CPU and hard disk when the speed of the CPU is very fast as compared to the speed of the hard disk? So, in the hard disk, data is already stored. So, depending upon the requirement, the data from hard disk, which is divided into logical blocks, is brought into the RAM. So, in the RAM, the block 1 student records are brought. CPU will search for a particular record in that particular block of the RAM. If the data or a particular record is found, that is, hit happens, the CPU will execute that query. Otherwise, the data from RAM again back to the particular block in the hard disk, and this process continues unless and until a particular record of a student for a roll number is found. So that is a scenario or a general architecture how a searching of a particular record takes place. Now, where indexing comes into the picture? Indexing is a mechanism used to speed up access to desired data. Consider the example of index in a book. If you want to find a particular chapter, there are two things. Either you go page by page, means for example, the chapter is on page 300, you have to perform 300 steps to find out that particular chapter, or you will directly go to the index of the book, you will find out the page number and directly go to that particular page. Indexing performs the same action for a database to find out the particular record. So how it is stored? An index file consists of records, which is called as index entries, in the form search key with a pointer to that record. Now, what is search key? Search key is an attribute or a set of attribute used to look up records in a file and pointer to that particular record. Search key is different from primary key or a candidate key. So, don't confuse between search key and the key attribute of our database. Any attribute will work as search key depending upon the requirement. Index files are typically much smaller than original file. Remember one thing, because of which there is a speed up in the mechanism. Now, two basic kinds of indices, ordered indices and hash indices. Ordered indices, which are search keys, are stored in a sorted order, and hash indices, search keys are distributed uniformly across buckets using a hash function. Now, on which basis, which indices you are going to use for your database? there are different types of indices, ordered indices, hash indices. Again, there ordered indices are divided into different types of indices. We cannot directly say that this particular mechanism is best or this particular mechanism is worst. This depends on that particular technique. Now, on which basis you are going to decide which index method is good? There are different index evaluation metrics, access type, the type of access supported efficiently. For example, records with a specified value in the attributes or records with an attribute value falling in a specified range of values. Access time, the time it takes to find a particular data atom. Insertion time, as a name suggests or as a name indicate, this time it takes to insert a new data atom. But remember one thing, insertion time also include a time to find a particular data atom plus time it takes to insert a new data atom. Deletion time, time it takes to delete a particular data atom or a set of data atom from database. Like insertion time, deletion time also include searching time plus deletion time. Space overhead, additional space occupied by index structure. So these are different attributes which decides the particular index method best suited for your database criteria. Now, all of you students, please pause your video and try to answer the thing. Question: using index method, whether it optimizes query performance or whether it degrades query performance. So, it is true or false? Naturally, it is true. Why? Because with the help of index method, searching becomes fast, and as searching becomes fast, deletion and insertion also become fast as compared to direct insertion or deletion in a database. Now, what are the different types of index? Index, there are three basic division: primary indexing, clustering indexing and secondary indexing. Primary indexing again divide into dense and sparse. Okay. Now, what is primary index? Primary index is defined on an ordered data file. The one important key or one important word is here, ordered data file. The data file is ordered on a key field, and the key field is generally the primary key of the relation. So, read again carefully. Primary index is defined on an ordered data file. The data file is ordered on a key field, and the key field is generally the primary key of the relation. Now, data file. Data or the data of a database is stored on the hard disk in the form of file. That file may be ordered or unordered. What are these ordered? What are these unordered? We will cover in the next session. But primary index is defined on an ordered data file using a key attribute. Next type is secondary index. Secondary index may be generated from a field which is a candidate key and has a unique value in every record, or a non-key with duplicate values. So, secondary key may be generated from a field which is a candidate key and has a unique value in every record, or non-key with a duplicate values. So, secondary index may be applicable to unique key or non-key. And the third one is clustering index. So, clustering index is defined on an order data file. Order data file, data is stored in order, and the data file is ordered on a non-key field. So primary, secondary and clustering are the three types of indices. Primary, order data file. Secondary, order or non-ordered. And clustering, on order data file. Again, on which key you are applying, that decides primary, secondary and clustering. So primary, clustering and secondary. Primary again divided into dense and sparse. So this is a reference. Thank you.